still available through the Liberty Gospel Church bookshops and its website. On the 3rd of July, a few weeks before the anti-witchcraft conference was disrupted by supporters of Helmut Pabio, five men turned up at Kral. Originally, they claimed they were there to make a donation. They were accompanied by Mrs. Okpabio's lawyer. In fact, they were the police and were looking for Sam Itawuma, Kran's director, and his wife, Ellie.
I saw a very tall man walk towards me to my kitchen, asking me, "Who are you? Where is that man, Sam?" I said, "Who? What happened? Who are you? What do you want?" He said, "Shut up, woman. Are you not Elizabeth? Are you not the nurse?" I said, "Ah, yes, am I." He said, "Okay, you are under arrest."
Sam suspected something was wrong and barricaded himself in the office.
I had to call the divisional police officer, who now told me that he's not aware of policemen who have come to the center. So I now knew that those guys have come to kill me.
They bring out some pistol. They shoot to me. "If you think we are not serious, we are serious. If you are not serious, we are going to shoot you right now."
I broke the ceiling from here. I got in from inside the roof. Then I got to the room at the extreme end, the other side. Then I hit the ceiling the second time. I jump in. I had to jump from the window here, coming out. And this is where I entered the bush.
Destroyed the door and they found no Sam inside. I was like, "Oh, thank God."
Some of the children decided to intervene, and it's alleged that two were knocked unconscious and had to be hospitalised. One was Indoneset Akpan, age 12.
Police beat me, take stick and beat me. The pus come out in my ear, I faint.
They took me down to police station and then throw me inside the cell.
I cannot talk, I cannot eat since last week, I cannot eat.
It's okay, don't worry. Okay.
Seven days before the armed plainclothes officers raided Kran, Mrs. Okpabio submitted a formal written complaint to the police. In it, she accused Sam, Ellie, and others of being fraudsters and asked the police to investigate. She claimed they were involved in using a clip from her film, End of the Wicked, in the dispatch's original documentary, to elicit donations under false pretenses. Mrs. Okpabio has also gone to the High Court, taking out an action against not only Sam and Ellie, but among others, the state governor, the commissioner of police, and Gary Foxcroft. In a wide-ranging lawsuit, she's calling for Kran to be closed and for all the children to be taken into state care. She's also alleging that assassins were hired by some of those she cites to kill her. And she's also demanding around £800 million for what she calls the unlawful and unconstitutional infringement of her constitutional rights to the belief in God, Satan, witchcraft, heaven and hellfire. After repeated requests, Helen Okpabio and her lawyer stated that all the allegations made against them were false and that they couldn't comment on the allegations because of the ongoing High Court action.
So people have accused me that we are fighting a war against Christendom. No. We are trying to protect the rights of children. So it's important for the world to know, yes, that here in Akwa Ibom State, you have a government that cares and is proactive.
Such was the impact of Dispatch's first report that much has changed for Africa's witch children. Apart from the introduction of the Child Rights Act, some churches that branded children as witches have been closed. Pastors and parents found to have abused children are arrested and now even make front page news. One such story involved the life-threatening burns inflicted on three little sisters under the age of six in Calabar. Their father and stepmother believed they were witches bringing ill fortune on the family.
We got a distress call from the community that there are three children here that are almost dying. We could not rescue them because the stepmother was violent. She resisted, so we brought in the police and forcefully took the children away.
Not all such children are lucky enough to be rescued by the authorities. Like 9-year-old Effion, the young girl Gary Foxcroft found by the side of the road when he first returned to Akwa Ibom. She'd been abandoned by her family, who think she's a witch. Together with co-worker Lucky, he goes in search of her father.
Well done.
We are not here to arrest you. We are here to talk to you about your daughter, which I know you've had the information already. He believes the child is a witch. He said it wasn't from the church, but all of a sudden the villagers started accusing the church. They accused the girl of eating up the stepmother's clothes. You know, and stuff like that. As far as that belief is there.
When I see a girl like this so thin, I think to myself, how can any human being treat another human being like this? It's as if you've been trying to kill her by not giving her food. You understand? And for me, I think this is very terrible.
I'm a fisherman before, and now I don't have anything to do to maintain her. That's the reason.
If you don't feed her for one more week, she will die. Not like you, you're okay. She is starving, she's so malnourished, she will die. And then is that not murder? If you had more money, would you care for her?
Come on, we are going to work with you now. And this is what we are going to do. Anybody that calls your child a witch, even your wife, will be prosecuted.
10 years imprisonment. So if you call a child, any of you, if you call a child a witch, you go to prison for 10 years. You understand?
Gary decides to give the man a loan to buy new nets and an anchor for his boat, provided he agrees to take his daughter back.
I promise that after being empowered by Stepping Stones Nigeria, I will no longer regard my daughter as a witch. I will take care of her with the income I make from my fishing business. So he has written his name. He has very good handwriting.
Okay, good.
And signed.
Wonderful. Well done. If I return in 1 week's time or any time in the future, and I ask Afiong if anybody has called her witch, yeah, I will speak to the governor and I will bring his men and the police down here, and whoever she tells me has called her witch will go to prison for 10 years.
I thought, you know, if some point in my lifetime this belief and abuse stops, then that'd be a result. Now I'm thinking, well, maybe if we use our funds right and we, you know, play our cards right, then maybe 5 to 10 years we can put an end to it. So on that level, I'm quite optimistic, definitely.
Very fantastic having the children today, and the children are so happy to be part of this swimming expedition. As you can see, they are so happy.
For most of them, it's the first time to ever having even seen the sea, never mind go and swim in it. They're having lots of fun, and it's good to see. That's the main thing.